Hello, I'm Jonathan Wyner, and welcome to another episode of Are You Listening? Today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about streaming services and thinking about mastering four streaming services. People like to talk a lot these days about mastering four streaming services, and you have to wonder why. What's different about mastering for a streaming service than mastering for anything else, for vinyl, for CD, for, you know, any format that you can imagine, and what's different? So maybe I need to break this apart for a minute and say that there are two issues here. One is the lossy codec that streaming services use, and we have to think a little bit strategically about preparing masters that are going to get turned into lossy files. By lossy, I mean MP3 or AAC or Ogg Vorbis or anything where the goal is to reduce the bandwidth requirement or the file size so it's easy to share or easy to broadcast over the internet. The other issue has to do with level and whether or not the listener is going to play back the audio peak normalized or loudness normalized. These two issues are kind of connected, but they're kind of not connected. And they really are very separate. Quick bit of perspective that comes from thinking back about why we're even talking about this. In general, maybe over the last 50 years or so, since the early 1960s, people have owned music. In other words, they have owned a physical object or hosted a file on a hard drive that lives locally on their machine. The reason that that's different than a streaming service is that once you get the audio, it exists in whatever resolution and at whatever level you bought it at. Right? So nobody's going to go into your house and change the level or the resolution of your turntable. Your needle might wear down. You might have to replace it at some point or get a new stylus for your turntable. But in general, you've got the audio. You own it. It lives in your house. With streaming services, this is more like broadcast radio, right? Where audio is uploaded to a service and then it's distributed. Whether you're playing back at home through a laptop or a desktop machine, through a media player that's integrated into a home service, or through something that might feed your television set or a soundbar, or you're listening on your phone or your tablet. Each one of those streams might be slightly different, and each service might handle your audio slightly differently. If you're out in the wild listening on your phone, the streaming service might reduce the bandwidth and you may hear a slightly modified version of the audio. In fact, if you have a really poor cell connection, in some cases, the service might even throttle the audio down to a mono playback of your audio. It's not as if we master something for every single different streaming service in every eventuality. That would be crazy. That would take too much time, and we can't anticipate what's going to happen in every instance. It does, however, lead us to have to think about our mastering so that in every playback paradigm, the audio doesn't completely fall apart. So this is one of the reasons that we make sure we pay attention to mono compatibility, for instance. Another thing that we think about is how do we set the levels in our audio so that when it goes out to the streaming service, it will sound as good as possible. Mastering engineers, well, we care about the fidelity and we are nerds and we are trying to eke out that last little bit of audio goodness, right? So let's take a look at some of the things, the adjustments that we can make when we're preparing audio for streaming services. I'm going to use the master assistant in Ozone as a way of illustrating one of the best practices. So I'm going to hit play on a track that I might be working on and make sure that the destination is selected as streaming. I'm going to disregard some of the other choices right now because I just want to focus on this one particular decision point. So the master assistant is going to do some thinking about tonal balance, is going to do some thinking about the musical dynamics within the track, the technical dynamics within the track, the overall level setting of the track. But there's one thing that it's going to do that is very specifically tied to this idea of streaming and lossy audio. I'll click accept. and stop the audio, and I'm going to look at the maximizer, the limiter. Typically, the limiter is the last thing in the chain, and the ceiling is the thing that defines the level of the audio. And you'll notice it sets it to -1 dBFS. The reason for that choice has to do with what happens to the audio when it gets encoded into a lossy file format. If I check the audio and look at my output meter, I'll see that the peak level is -1. If I implement a lossy codec, for instance, MP3 at 192 kilobits per second, now I'm going to listen through the codec and set the codec for playing back as if I was sending this out as an MP3 at 192 kilobits per second. And you will notice that the peak level now on output is somewhat higher than it was before. Okay? This is a natural byproduct of taking a WAV file or AIF file and turning it into a lossy file. The peak level ends up being different at the output than it is in the lossless version. You can't avoid it, but we can prepare for it by lowering the level of our master so that when it gets turned into a lossy file, it won't overdrive the output. If you're working on a genre that's very, very, or if you're working on a track that's set to a very high RMS level, and there's a low crest factor between peak and average, then you may notice that you still get some overlevels, even if you set the output to -1. Our goal here is not to completely eliminate distortion in the lossy file, but at least to reduce it. So this is one of the implications of mastering for streaming services and thinking about streaming services. The other aspect of this that we think about has to do with loudness. And here's where things get, well, somewhat controversial. In a perfect world, you would be creating a master for a playback presentation to a listener that would be according to a peak normalized paradigm and one that would be set for the loudness normalized playback of whatever streaming service someone is listening to. You should also understand that streaming services offer, not all of them, but some of them, the possibility of turning off loudness normalization or turning it on. The implications of this are maddening because it means that you can't know for sure whether a listener is going to go from your song to the next song they listen to in a way where the streaming service is going to match the level or it's not going to match the level. The question comes into our head, do I have to push the level up really, really high so that my track sounds as loud as the next thing that's going to play? Or if I push the level up really high and the streaming service then turns it down, is it going to sound worse? Have I pushed the level so high so that it ends up damaging the audio? And then when it gets turned down, that damage becomes even more apparent than it might have been otherwise. So there's a conundrum, there's a problem here. Many people will use the idea of loudness normalization as an argument for not pushing level at all. And I think that's a mistake. If we use any standard playback level as an arbitrary way of defining the artistry of our work, we run the risk of making mistakes, or at least not making tracks sound as good as we can, and not making our tracks work for the artist as well as they possibly can work. So ultimately, for my money, what I prefer is to make a track sound as good as possible at as high a level as possible. That's an abstracted idea. There's no single number that I'll use. It varies with genre. It varies with artist and what the artist needs. But to make sure I'm making something sound as good as possible so that it will work in any different playback paradigm. There are some thoughts about streaming and mastering audio in this day and age of streaming and how we think about preparing audio for streaming out to the listener. In the next episode, I'm going to dive into loudness, which is a related topic, but I'm going to talk about loudness on its own, for its own sake, in mastering. So I hope to see you there. Also, if you have any questions or comments, but especially questions, please leave them in the comments area underneath this video. At the end of this season, we're going to do another mailbag episode, and we're going to go through, and if we find that there are 100 questions about a particular thing, I'll try to answer that question. And if you ask a brilliant question, I'm going to answer that question too. So please let us know your thoughts and join me for another episode of Are You Listening?